Alla Crypto Conference a Milano un mesetto fa ho avuto l'opportunità e il piacere di scambiare due chiacchiere, 5 minuti, con Tech Kia, il direttore di Binance X, il ramo ricerca e sviluppo di Binance. Abbiamo parlato principalmente del Binance DEX e della Binance Chain, concentrandoci su qualche aspetto tecnico, nonché i futuri immediati sviluppi della piattaforma. Se avete dubbi o non capite qualcosa di quello che diciamo, vi incentivo naturalmente a fare domande, a chiederle nei commenti, così approfondiamo certi concetti. Buonasera amici criptoinvestitori e ben ritrovati a tutti quanti. Oggi un contenuto un po' diverso dal solito per movimentare la situazione in un mercato così fermo come quello di Bitcoin attuale, che dà poca gioia. Vi propongo appunto questa intervista che ho finito recentemente di montare con TechKey. Ho fatto un paio di sottotitoli molto semplici, molto essenziali, proprio per permettervi di capirla, anche se non masticate molto bene l'inglese, in quanto è in lingua, insomma. Quindi, appunto, vi dicevo, fate domande se non capite qualche concetto, perché è interessante, secondo me, approfondire anche qualche lato tecnico delle piattaforme che siamo abituati ad utilizzare. Vi ricordo che se apprezzate sempre i miei video e i miei contenuti, cortesemente lasciatemi un like anche a questo video, mi incentivate tantissimo a dare il massimo. Iscrivetevi al canale, campanellina per essere sempre sul pezzo, e iscrivetevi anche agli altri miei canali social, link in descrizione. Basta chiacchiere e andiamo a vedere questa piccola intervista. Hi Tech, please
Hello.
Introduce yourself.
Yeah, so I'm Tech. I'm from Binance X. It's basically an innovation arm of Binance.
Yeah, nice. And I'd like to talk to you, Tech, about the decentralized exchange. So, which are the reasons why a trader should choose the DEX over the centralized exchange?
Yeah, so the decentralized exchange, any decentralized exchange has several differences. So when a user goes to a decentralized exchange, the user has custody of their own funds or own crypto.
Yeah.
So when they trade on the DEX, they never give the crypto to another entity. On a central exchange, as you know, you have to deposit into Binance or some exchange. So that's one difference. Another is that when you trade on a decentralized exchange, you are largely anonymous. You don't need to give up your identity. And some people might treasure their or prefer to be private, to have privacy over their trading activities. And then on central exchange, as you know, it's not as private. So
Yeah, those are some good reasons.
yeah.
And it's a little more difficult to trade on the DEX over the centralized exchange, isn't it?
Yes, exactly. So like I said, you need to be able to know how to, you know, secure your own
Your own
crypto.
crypto, yeah.
And then you also need to use a client to issue orders on the Binance chain. It's slightly slower than the centralized exchange as well. So you need to learn a few other things that you didn't need to learn for the central exchange.
The speed of the matching of the trades is determined by I think, the block times, isn't it?
Exactly. So we do have a very fast block time compared to other
It's
DEXs.
about 1 second.
1 second,
Yeah.
yeah. And it's very, very fast in it's final when you confirm each block. But in the central exchange, of course, you know, things are much faster.
Much
You don't need to
faster, yeah.
wait for block.
There are pros and cons, we
Pros
can
and
say.
cons, yeah.
Yeah, about the difficulty is lowered by the fact that you can use a trust wallet
Yeah.
to access the DEX and to operate and trade on the DEX.
Exactly. So we support many wallets, and trust wallet is you know, Binance's wallet that we acquired. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible, you know, through integration with third-party wallets, as well as innovating on our own trust wallet.
And just a curiosity, how many users do the DEX has compared to the centralized exchange?
Yeah, definitely a much lower number. I don't know the exact number, and probably nobody knows because, you know, there's no identity on there.
There's no data about them.
Exactly. You can actually look at go to the Explorer, or
Yeah.
you know, everybody can look at the number of transactions, number of unique addresses, and make a educated guess on how many users there are. But definitely compared to central exchange, way lower.
Way
Yeah.
lower, yeah.
We only just
Of
started
course.
also. Yeah.
Yeah. And about the assets, there are much more assets on the DEX than the centralized exchange.
Yeah.
Why?
First of all, I think because it's a public chain and we only just started, we tend to take a more open-minded approach. So even though we do have, you know, the same baseline for evaluating token projects to be listed on
the quality of the project.
Yeah, there's some things that we don't compromise on centralized and decentralized. But we take a more open-minded approach, so mm-hmm. more projects get listed on the DEX.
We can say it's easier to be listed on the DEX.
You can say that.
Okay. Yeah. And about the Binance chain, the DEX can trade just assets issued on the Binance chain, isn't it?
So as of about 3 weeks ago, we did a hard fork with this new feature that is specified in BEP3. BEP stands for Binance Evolution Proposal,
yeah,
which is the community voted or community proposed feature enhancements.
To improve the chain.
Exactly, to improve the chain. So BEP3 allows for pegging between different chains, so between Binance chain and another chain with a bridge. Yeah. So you can actually issue tokens from other chain and peg them to issue tokens on Binance chain and peg them to
the original
chain. Yeah, so you can actually trade.
You use the original token as a collateral, and issue a new token on the Binance chain to trade on.
Exactly.
I see. And which are the next steps in the development of the Binance chain?
So we recently open source a TSS, library threshold signature scheme, which allows any developer to do things like a custody solution on top of Binance chain. But overall, I think we tend to let the community decide what features we want to include in our Binance chain through the BEP BEP proposal process.
Okay, I see. So it's a continuous development.
Continuous development through community, what the community wants, really. Yeah.
I see. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you.